I want to present you our experiences with introducing of games to the didactics. I come from AGH, University of Science and Technology, located in Cracow, Poland. And we work in team, mixed team from our university and the Polish Academy of Sciences, one colleague, which was former colleague in our university. let me introduce our environment. We let didactics on the bachelor studies and master of science studies in three directions. Chemical engineering, which is rather fuels engineering than chemical. Power production, which is energy engineering, and renewable energy and energy management, which is new direction started this year. two games are introduced for the students of power production, power grid game, which is appropriate for these students and contain some elements of business game, and maze-like game called Organic Labyrinth for bachelor labor students on the chemical engineering, fuels engineering. First game is based on the game published by Friedman Friese. It was called Power Grid. Two examples were introduced to Power Grid game, United States Power Grid and German Power Grid. We modified the game to use in our country. New rules are introduced to the game, the map of a country with main cities, main producers, card of development, card of risk, and game was adapted to the market and law in Poland. Next modification is introducing of two kind of players. In original game, one kind of player exists. We have two kinds of players, producers and distributors, which is accordingly to the Polish law in energy sector. These actors could take the same territory and could interact each other, may make the agreements, make the alliances, and so on. this is a modified map for the power grid of Poland. I come from Krakow. This is a city located on the south of Poland. some property cards for the city on the left and for the region, Małopolska Voivodeship, which describe the region not only technically, but either socially, how many habitants, how many users, domestic users and industrial users are on the region, the energy cost, and so on, so on. Some rules are introduced to the games. Energy market approximately is treated like a real energy market. Three kind of actors, producers, distributors, and users are introduced. Initial money for every player is given. Possibly, there is a possibility of action emission. First player in cycle is selected on the basis of a least number of on dice. Player on move could trade with other players, but other players could not trade with remaining players. Player on the move throw the dice, and the dice number decides even number. Player draw a card of development. This development means new invention in the energy sector. Some foundation for the technologies and so on. Odd number on the dice means drawing the card of risk. Risk is natural catastrophe, the changing in law, changing in the interest by the user, and so on. Both card types, development and risk, need money to realize. So player make a decision about usage, except obligatory card of risk, which means naturally events or low events. Player can make alliances and agreements. What are outcomes for the game? As the rules are adopted to Polish energy law and European policies, students learn to the energy system rules out of boring lectures and seminars. Lectures are very boring, and rate of students after lectures is very low. When team plays as one actor in the game, the leadership and team cooperation skills are improved. It was surprised under the game, in team, the leader appear, the technical leader appear, technical officer, and so on. The roles arise naturally. Teacher instructor can evaluate the student in the different conditions than traditional classes. It gives possibility to teacher to evaluate student in different environment. Sometimes student which come to exam cannot pass exam because lack of information, lack of possibility to interpret the information. In the game, it comes naturally. And next game used for the organic chemistry, the maze game. This is an exemplary map of organic labyrinth. Dependently on the place in the map, the rules are used. Two set of cards is necessary. Questions and answer, and the plan of the labyrinth. The plan is known only to the master of the game, or master at the game, the Meg. Meg guides players through the maze, and Meg knows the map. Players don't know the map. Players draw the card of question, and Meg take the corresponding card of answer, evaluate the answer of the player. In this moment, we could arise the skill of problem solving, because some of cases could be simple, some of question could be the problem question to project the system of changes to reaching the effect. It depends on the place on maze, I show you in a moment. Another rules are players throw the dice and move the number of fields accordingly to the number of dice, except when they encounter a crossroads, when the question is drawn. Right answer reveal the good direction. The mag show go on the left, go directly, or go on the right. In other case, students choose the way randomly or resign of further movement. And it gives different possibilities. In a green color, I show the way, optimal way to go through the labyrinth. We have some places in which question appears. First, first crossing, second crossing, third crossing, and so on, up to 13 crossing. 13 question appears under the game. And what is crucial, for example, here, this is a crucial because selection of direction increase the number of steps by 36 and 36 back, what change the final number of steps. In the right way, it is 67 steps. In the wrong way, it is over 150 steps. This property of the game gives the possibility to evaluate the student, make the rate of organic chemistry knowledge. But in this place, in my opinion, the question should be simpler. In a not so important places, question could be more complex to solve problems. And outcomes of organic labyrinth is student gain knowledge even when there were gaps of knowledge before. Students check and consolidate knowledge. and teacher could evaluate the students under the play. Both games were assessed. Three types of outcomes are developed under the games: knowledge, skills, and social competences. Business competences are also developed in the first game, in the power grid. Problem-solving competences are developed in the second game. The survey was made. Four questions we ask students: is the use of game a good alternative to other teaching methods? Did playing a game increase your knowledge? Did playing game increase your ratings? And has playing the game increased your general outcome in terms of knowledge, skills, and social competences? And results are here. Results are better for power grid game, which is a more dynamic game, more complex game, and bigger number of skills are realized in power grid. Maze game is not so excited like power grid. I observe when team plays in power grid, sometimes very complex discussion, sometimes funny, sometimes dramatic discussion appears under power grid. In maze game, such situation not appear. Summarizing, games fulfill the role of didactic tool, making the learning process more attractive and diverse. Two games appears to have different potentials. Further improvement is possible for games scenarios and the media used. Games are prepared in paper mode, but it is possible to change the games to the electronic mode and use on the portals and use in flipped classroom idea. Students could work before classes, under the classes, and after classes. Playing the didactic games is rather extracurricular activity. It is not possible to fulfill all program with using games. So thank you very much. If you have a question, I am for your disposition.
Thank you.